Hello, Sagittarius. Welcome to your March 2017 General Monthly Tarot Scope reading. Thank you so much for joining me. Please keep in mind these are general readings, so be sure to watch your sun, your moon, and your rising sign just to get, you know, a full picture of information and messages for you. Sometimes one sign resonates or more than the others and vice versa. Okay, so let's move on. If you haven't signed up for our newsletter, please do so. I'll be sending out your mid-month channeled writing updates for all 12 signs. You'll receive that right in your inbox. Also, if you haven't joined us on Facebook or Instagram, please do so. And if you'd like to order a reading, you're more than welcome to. All of the links that you need are in the description box below for your clicking pleasure. All right, Sagittarius, let's see. What do we have for you for March 2017? Give me a second to take in these images. I am shuffling the Universal Weight Pocket Tarot deck. I use these to clarify cards if I need extra messages. Boom, Queen of Wands just literally flew out, flipped over. Okay, this is leadership card. that's great. And look at that. That flipped over and you have this in your reading. This is a double whammy, so let's remember that I pulled this out because, I didn't pull it out, it fell out, flipped over. This is definitely fire energy. This is leadership role, taking a stand, moving along in your life, getting things done. Very interesting. Anyways, not every sign gets clarity messages. It just depends on how the reading goes and if I need to or not. So, but I like to shuffle anyway while I take in the images because it helps me focus. That's interesting. Very interesting. Very interesting. Funny dynamic going on here in your life, Sagittarius, between you and somebody else or you and multiple people. It depends on whether it's in your career, your professional life, or your personal life. I just don't know whether this is with family or not. All right, let's move on to the messages and we'll go from there. So this card here represents the situation that this is either, you know, pointing directly to you or the environment you're in, the energy swirling around you, the interaction that you have with other people in your life, again, whether professionally or personally. You have the Page of Wands in the reverse position. And again, this is your current situation. So this is basically receiving news that was upsetting, or maybe, you know, on the more severe end, maybe it was bad news. It left you frazzled, or it was just news. It could have just been shocking news that might have been a little bit more neutral, but it just maybe was surprising and it left you frazzled, a little dazed and confused. Or some of you dealt with a curt reply or letter of rejection or just rejection from somebody else. The letter of rejection could have been you applying to X, Y, and Z. You applied for a loan. You applied to a university. You applied for a grant or some other kind of program and there was a letter of rejection that came in. Or you applied for a job, or you've been applying for a lot of jobs and you keep getting, you know, rejection letters, or just rejection from somebody else in your life, whether professionally, personally, or romantically. So that's interesting. This can also indicate a quick dismissal, like somebody was a curt reply, they dismissed you, they kind of tossed you aside, or just dismissed your feelings and didn't really take them into account. Others of you could be dealing with naysaying, you know, gossipers, people who are kind of talking behind your back or making it difficult for you to shine your light or difficult for you to move on in some way. People are acting out towards you, whether this is professionally, personally, and or potentially job loss for some of you. Maybe some of you recently lost your job. Maybe the company downsized and it made a lot of cutbacks, and so you were one of the ones that got axed. You know, A-X-E-D, like an axe coming down, or something. Or maybe there was a loss of a client, loss of an account. Maybe you didn't lose your job, but part of your business, or, you know, that kind of thing. Or, you know what I'm trying to say. I don't know. So that's just for some of you, but others of you, this is not job or career. This is just one of those other things. Now, in the past, or the the challenge that you dealt with is the Six of Swords in the upright position. Some of you moved out and away, physically moved. You moved your home, you moved your city, your state, your country even. You moved away to have a new, fresh start for whatever reason, and it was challenging to do that. Maybe it was hard to leave that old chapter behind and all your familiar surroundings and go someplace new. Maybe you moved for a job opportunity. Others of you moved just to have a new start. Others of you moved because you're just tired of the life that you were living and you wanted, you know, to try something else, okay? So that's physical moving. This can also be moving of your job, your business, your studio, okay? So some of you maybe got a new job, so you moved to a new job, right? You left the old one behind. Others of you could be business owners where you closed one location and opened a new one, that kind of thing. Or maybe you're just opening new stores all around or what have you. Others of you moved away from drama, heartache, tough relationships, making tough decisions. You know, you left your stress, your baggage, your emotional trauma, dharma, and karma at the seashore. You got in this boat, you packed all your stuff, which was the Six Swords, and you paid this guy here to paddle you away. And now you're sailing towards calmer waters, brighter horizons, and better days. And this has been a challenge for you. While leaving baggage behind, okay, leaving baggage behind, leaving trauma, leaving old situations, relationships, toxic whatever, right? And or home life or physical nature, whatever it was a challenge. While it could have been good for you because you need that new start, always going through a transition is challenging, no matter what level it's on or what reason it's for. Some of you, it was challenging because it was just the transition. Others of you, it was challenging because you were forced into this transition, into this change. And so, you know, it was unexpected or you just weren't planning for it, okay? This is in the past, the challenge. This is your current situation dealing with a curt reply. Some of you moved. Maybe you moved to a new city. You've been applying for jobs. You keep getting rejected. And it's making this move and this transition difficult. Others of you moved or moved away from a situation because of a curt reply. Maybe somebody broke up with you or your spouse wanted a divorce or a situation ended or your business partner wanted out. And so therefore now you have to hurry up and jump through the hoops to end this association so that you can move on. So you see how this can manifest in a couple of different ways, but there's definitely something that was challenging in terms of moving on or moving out and away, dealing with somebody who dismissed you, curt reply, etc. Okay, now in the foundation position of what can't be changed, you have the Three of Cups in the reverse position. Now, this can indicate a couple things. This can indicate a cancellation of something, someone, some place, some event, cancellation of a job you were promised. Cancellation of a contract, a negotiation, a business deal. Cancellation of a profit coming in. Cancellation of a relationship. Cancellation of your marriage, you know, divorce. Cancellation of X, Y, and Z. Maybe a celebration, a party, a friendship, something within the family. So something could have been canceled or might still be canceled. You might be initiating it or somebody else is initiating it. And again, this is in the foundation of what can't be changed, directly under the card that's all about curt reply, rejection. Maybe somebody canceled something, you know, they initiated the canceling of something, leaving you disappointed, or vice versa. You know what I mean? So that can be going on here. Now, also, you know, this is a card that depicts friendship. Some of you could be dealing with a falling out in a friendship. You know, a long-standing friendship, a lifelong friend, a childhood friend, your best friend. Even somebody who's a friend, they were an acquaintance for a while, now they're a friend, you guys grew close, but you don't have a ton of history. You know, all kinds of weird scenarios can happen with friends, you know what I mean? So this could be something with that. Miscommunication with friends or friendship. Cups card, okay? Cups in the reverse position. Cups hold water. Water is emotion. Cups are running dry, running empty. Emotion is lacking. Heartache, heartbreak, breakup, separation, cutting of ties. Your cup not runneth over anymore, okay? Somebody, again, could have been the one to cancel it. Now, this card also indicates too much of a good thing, self-indulgence, overdoing it, drinking too much, you know, drinking, smoking, drugs, sex, rock and roll, shopping, spending money, gambling, whatever. Whatever it is, it's too much of a good thing that you're using as a crutch or you're overindulging in order to feel better about a situation. Or if it's not you, on the flip side, this could be somebody in your life who is doing that, thus putting strain on your current relationship or association with them, or thus ruining the relationship altogether. You could be dealing with somebody who has an addiction issue. Again, cups in the reverse position in a lot of different cards and suits can indicate addiction problems. You could be dealing with somebody who's like that. So, you know, it's one of those things. Now, on the marriage front, romance, partnership, marriage. In a marriage, this card can indicate, well, even a long-term partnership, this card can indicate in the reverse position, infidelity, promiscuity, cheating, deceit, and divorce. So, I don't know. For some of you, you know, you got this right, curt reply, upsetting news. You know what? You see where this is going? So it's not going to be that way for every Sagittarius. Again, so many scenarios. This could be going on anywhere from your personal life with family and friends to your romantic life to your professional life. Every Sagittarius is going to be different, but these are the energies that are swirling around you. So take the energies and apply them to your life and your situation and see what they mean for you. In the overview position, this is a card that indicates the energy over you, swirling around you, like helping to taint or paint the picture. Five of Pentacles reversed is a card that talks about basically a turn for the better coming in, especially around finances. So your faith is going to be restored around finances or hardship. Five of Pentacles upright is hardship. Poverty, loss of goods and services, loss of personal property, loss of money, loss of income, loss of assets, loss of property. You get what I'm saying. Feeling down and out, right? Left out in the cold. This in the reverse position is saying that your money problems are going to be improving if you've been having them. So improved working conditions for some of you if you've been having problems at work, difficulties with coworkers, with your boss, or even if you are self-employed and you have to go out and drum up business on your own, you don't eat unless you produce, this is going to be easier to start to do that now. Okay, energetically, the shift is coming in, right? So improved working conditions, improved cash flow, money, profit, income, raise, and or new opportunities. This can be a new business opportunity for some of you, or a new venture or a new creative project that has the potential to earn you some money. This is a card that talks about the end of poverty, the end of difficult times. So that's very good. And because this is in front of a church, it always brings with it the message of spiritual awareness. Because a lot of times through being down and out, going through a tough time financially, being, you know, at the bottom of the barrel, bare bones, robbing Peter to pay Paul, rubbing two dimes together, hoping to get a quarter, you know what I'm saying? Eating ramen noodles. This is when a lot of us reach our bottom and or personal epiphanies and or have breakthroughs. And we grow spiritually. So when this card is in the reverse, it can indicate major spiritual growth and awareness, connecting to the divine. Very good. I like that. So this is in the overview position. Now, whatever hardships you've been going through, like I said, there's a silver lining here. There's a reason for it. Spiritually based, on a soul level, on your level of evolution, your ascension, the lessons you need to learn in this life. Sagittarius, this card represents how you see yourself. And you have the Three of Swords in the reverse position. Hallelujah. Any heartache you sustained recently or as a result of whatever this is here is now coming to an end and or it's feeling better. The Three of Swords upright is definitely heartache, bleeding heart, sadness, loss, regret, despair, grief, shame, blame, guilt. Also, betrayal in terms of love, relationships, cheating, breakups, that kind of thing. You know, romance. It can also indicate just being betrayed by other people in your life, family, friends, coworkers, etc. So anybody who did you wrong, who trespassed against you, who hurt you in some way, who betrayed you in some way, whether professionally or personally, you are now coming out of the other side of that, which is good because, you, again, it confirms this card here in the reverse position. So you're coming through it. You know, you're coming out of the woods. You know what I'm saying? And you're gonna basically kind of birth a new you, so to speak. And in some regards, you are reinventing yourself as a result of this. So the pain is ending. The worst is over. The storm has come through. You're cleaning up the aftermath and you're recovering emotionally from it. While it still hurts, while it may linger on, every single day it gets a little easier, it gets better, and you become more busy and more focused on yourself and what you're doing to move forward instead of dwelling so much on the pain. Okay, so you're not going to be necessarily dwelling on the past and being stuck in regret. You want to be careful not to go down that road because it can be a slippery slope. So if you feel yourself doing that, you're getting a little too downward spiral down into the pit of hanging on to the past, you can't let it go, then you know this is something you need to work on. But for the majority of you, this is saying that you're going to be feeling better very shortly. Okay, in the future position, okay, and or the solution to this is you're going to basically be your own leader. That's what this is in a nutshell. Leadership, initiation, confidence, not arrogance and cockiness, just confidence, reassurance, you know, raising your self-esteem, your personal value, realizing that you are valuable, you do have something of value to offer. You have a story to tell. You have a skill or an asset to share. You have something to give back. You are worthy of being heard, that kind of thing. You're going to step out and be the queen of your own life. Even if you're a man, you could be a man with these characteristics. But this is definitely focusing on career and balancing your career with your family, balancing career with your home life. And just finding that balance so that you are now happier than you've ever been. Okay, and you're just going to be the one calling the shots. You're going to be ambitious. This is fire energy with the Rods card. So a lot of fire energy, burning away the old that needs to be burned off, burned away, die off, fall away. Burning away the drama, the dharma, the karma, the yesteryear baggage. Watching it all go up in flames so that you can be the phoenix who rises up out of the ashes. You're going to be, you know, metamorphosizing into the queen, stepping into the queen or king's shoes, hypothetically, and, you know, stepping out of the jack role, you know, like rags to riches, that kind of thing. Just reinventing yourself. That's what this is feeling like to me. So there's going to be a sense of independence here. There's going to be a sense of personal value leading to total self-sufficiency and the ability to do for yourself and not have to rely on anybody else. Okay. This card represents what you fear. And I find this very interesting because you have the Ace of Swords, which is a fabulous card. So why would you be scared of this? Well, the Ace of Swords is all about getting your personal power back. It's all about a sense of power, a sense of personal power, a sense of authority in your own life, finding your inner strength, having strength in adversity, you know, and just owning it. It's a swords card, so swords is air energy, and air is all about intellect, the power of your intellectual ability, communication, new ideas, and just exercising those, you know, implementing them, stepping forward on them and doing something with them. Definitely a card of mental energy, fresh ideas coming in, and just being very in tune. Mentally, you know, like sharp, that's what I'm trying to say. 10 steps ahead of the game, right? This is also a card that talks about something good coming out of something bad or the silver lining. And it's coming into you, to you, by divine guidance, divine inspiration, divine timing. A hand coming out of the cloud, you now handing you a sword to weed whack your garden and slay the dragons. You're wearing the crown, meaning you've done your time, you've paid your dues, and now it's time to stand and be Your Majesty. And then you have growth on either side. Fresh new growth, blooming flowers, symbolizing you blooming and blossoming into Sagittarius 2.0, right? And just rising above it all. So why do you fear this? This is in the position of what you're scared of. Are you scared of full-on success? Are you scared of all your dreams finally coming true? Are you scared of the freedom to be you and step forward and build something and do something? Are you scared of the responsibility that comes along with that? Are you scared of the new reputation, being in the limelight? You know, people can be scared of success in many different ways for many different reasons, but this is just here for you to try to think for yourself. It's a rhetorical question for you. Every Sagittarius watching this video, deciding for yourself what it is that you fear. And then working to overcome that fear, because look at this. Spirit is trying to hand it to you on a silver platter. Your biggest dream, your biggest prayer wants to be answered. They want you to do well. They want to see you grow, blossom, achieve. But there's something holding you back. So is it a paradigm? Is it conditioning? Is it your mommy told you you'd never be good enough? Is it not feeling up to the task? Is it just not having enough confidence in yourself? What is it? Whatever that is for you personally, that's the area that you need to work on, strengthening and overcoming, so that you can step forward, you can put this crown on, and you can tell everybody else to go pound salt. How do you like that? So that's what you fear. In the outcome position, you have the Knight of Pentacles. Hallelujah. I like it. Money card in the upright position. Money, money, money. Coming in for Sagittarius. This is also slow and steady growth, tangible progress. A knight coming in here bringing important news for you, or an event coming in. So this could be a new opportunity revolving around money, revolving around opportunity, whether it's business, project, venture, you know what I'm trying to say, partnership, okay? Whatever. So yeah, that's good. It's very good. And this is in the outcome position, which means it's going to be happening. Okay. So get ready. Because when this event happens or when this news comes in, it's going to bring with it open doors. It's going to bring with it opportunity. So news or opportunity related to money, related to career, business, profit, negotiation, contracts, property, right? Partnerships, did I say that already? Material concerns, right? So employment, you know, all of that's tied in here. Financial security, nonetheless, building your financial security, your foundation, and enough, you know, to feel solid in your own future. You are on the verge of new and unexpected opportunities, new and unexpected source of prosperity and abundance. So get ready for it, Sagittarius, because you know, if you fear this, okay, if you fear this, then you're going to push it away. And you don't want to do that, because then that's your law of attraction. You don't want to push this away. When universe wants to hand this to you on a silver platter, you graciously accept it and say thank you. Attitude of gratitude. Spread it, you know, spread that around to create more of it, build the momentum, and universe will keep rewarding you. So this is great news. I love this. This is a positive outcome for Sagittarius. You're going to be harvesting the fruits of your labor. This can even be a card of recognition. You being recognized by others, getting an award or a pat on the back or a nice compliment in front of people. You know what I mean? Yeah, a little bit in the limelight there. And, you know, don't shy away from it. Put a smile on your face. Stand there loud and proud. You know what I'm saying? Don't be arrogant. Just be humble, yet, you know, good. Feel good about yourself. You have every right to. And obviously, from these cards, you've earned it. And whatever happened here emotionally or whatever you're moving away from, again, you're coming out the other side of it. Okay? Yeah. Some of you, somebody died, by the way. And that was the blow that you sustained. And it was unexpected for the most part. A lot of you, it was unexpected. It happened out of the blue. Some of you kind of expected it because the person was sick. But nonetheless, whenever somebody passes, it's always a blow and it's always a little bit of a shock. And so that is what kind of hindered your forward moving progress here. And that is what brought a lot of heartache. And it could have happened around the holidays. So you're moving through that grief and you're coming out the other side. And now it's like with the change of the seasons and spring coming in, meaning new life is coming in, fresh air, more sunshine, lots of buds, you know what I mean? Greenery, lushness sprouting all around us. It's a time to allow that change to happen and to allow that, to allow the change to happen and to allow that personal growth to take effect. It's okay. It's okay to let go, especially if some of you dealt with somebody who passed away. It's all right to let them go. Because trust me, they're on the other side. They're pain-free. They're happy. They're around you, even though you don't know it. And they don't want to see you suffer. They don't want to see you sad. They don't want to see you holding on to grief that is hindering your life here on this earth plane. So move forward and don't be scared of it. You are the boss, and what you say will all of a sudden open doors and wonderful things are coming in for you. So get excited. All right, Sagittarius, beautiful. I'm not going to clarify this because I feel like that was neat and clean. You write me and let me know what you thought of it. If it did not resonate with you, watch your rising and moon sign. Let's move on to your oracles. Ooh, interesting. I haven't gotten these cards at all for any of the other signs. So this is fresh and personal for you. Like personalized for you is what I meant to say. Spirit wants you to create a sacred space. Take time for the dreamer in you. Find your power in stillness. In your sacred space is the peace you seek. Yes, especially moving forward. If you are coming through a time of sadness, pain, and heartache, whether it was somebody that passed, whether it was something in your career, whether it was something in your personal life, romance, whatever, you need to create the sacred space, because as you come out of that, come out of the woods, you know, birth through to the other side, have that breakthrough, now you're in a mode of healing. And you can't just go back to the way things were before. You got to create a sacred space in order to allow more healing to come in order to allow you to grow, evolve, and develop, in order for you to continue to lick your wounds and to love and nurture yourself, okay? Sacred space is really important moving forward, especially as new opportunities come in for you. Take the time for the dreamer in you. If you're a Sagittarius who has put your dreams on hold for a while, now is the time. Spring is the perfect time to get back in touch with ourselves and to watch something grow and blossom out of ourselves. It's the perfect time to dream and to manifest. I love it. Wow, Saggies, you are a powerful light worker. I've never pulled this card, for anybody, for any of the readings, any of the clients, and or in the March videos. So you're the first, the one and the only. My Saggies are light workers out there. It, at least this month, that's what Spirit's saying. A lot of people who watch my videos, no matter what sign you are light workers, because you wouldn't be drawn to my work if you weren't. You know what I mean? Okay, we're all in this together. It is safe for you to be powerful. Your spiritual power brings great blessings in loving service to the divine. It is safe for you to be powerful. It is safe for you to be powerful. And this also came out earlier in... Let me see if I can find it. Oh, I might have shuffled it back in the deck. It's somewhere in there. Anyways, it came out. Remember when I was shuffling earlier and it popped out and flipped over? This card came out twice. Spirit is saying it is safe for you to be powerful. It is safe for you to step into a role of power, authority, and leadership, to call the shots and state, you know, draw your boundaries, make your claims. You know what I mean? All that stuff. Declare that I am queen, I am king, and this is what's going to happen now. You know what I mean? And not in an arrogant way, like I said, but you're a powerful light worker. Your spiritual power brings great blessings and loving service to the divine. Whatever that entails for you. If you're watching my videos and you're like, I'm a lawyer, I have no intention of being a light worker in terms of doing all this spiritual woo-woo stuff for a living. I'm perfectly happy being a lawyer. You're a light worker as a lawyer. You're helping clients in the lawyer way. You know what I'm saying? Light working happens in every profession. So don't think that you have to sit down and meditate on a daily basis and wear chakra beads and, you know, connect your crown chakra to the divine to be a light worker. No, there's light workers that work as doctors and nurses and, you know, utility workers and bus drivers. I mean, you know, I just saw a news story the other day. I forget what state it was in, but there was a female bus driver. She, you know, she was driving like the local RTA buses or whatever in a city. And she was going to pull over. It was late at night. She was going to pull over and take a 10-minute break. Instead, something told her to keep driving. So she kept driving, drove down the road, and she saw a 5-year-old little boy running down the street, half naked, crying and lost in like 20-degree weather. So she stopped, ran out, rescued him, brought him on the bus, you know, covered him in her winter coat, went to the local store, got him a snack, and called the police. You know, took him to the emergency room, found his parents. That's a light worker. You know, if it wasn't for her, that little boy could have run into some trouble or gotten killed or froze to death. You know what I'm saying? So light working comes in all shapes and sizes. It doesn't matter what you do for a living. It's how you are. It's the example that you live. It's the actions that you take. It's living with integrity. All right? I love it. Release and surrender. It's time to release that old baggage, heal those old wounds, surrender to the grief, the sadness, be humble with it, sit in it, own it, and let it go. We shower you with blessings of our radiant love. Open your arms and release the challenges that you've held tightly gripped within your hands. Open your hands, arms, and heart to our love and assistance. And this is from the angel deck. So to your angels, your guardian angels, your God-appointed angels, your spirit guides, the good Lord above, even the archangels. Very much so, yes, indeedy. This is from the angels. So pray to them, ask for help and assistance, but don't forget to give them permission because we have free will. It's a universal law that they cannot interfere or work miracles unless we give them permission. So you can pray and ask for help and assistance all day long, but you will not receive an answer unless you give them permission. That's what people always forget. So try it and watch it go to work in your life. All right, Sagittarius, wow, what a reading. What a reading. Write me, let me know what you thought of it. Again, watch your rising and your moon sign if it didn't make sense for you. Thank you so much for joining me. Mwah, mwah. I hope you have a great month and we'll see you back here in April. Bye.